Luba, and I love to paint in the traditional Russian decorative painting styles. As you can see here, I have painted this keyboard and the speakers in a Russian decorative painting called Zhostovo style. And in this video, I would like to show you how I will paint this computer box in a similar style to this. So if you want to do one yourself, you can also follow along, and I'll show you my step-by-step process of how to do it. Now, I've been painting in this style for a few years now, and I do it a little bit differently from the traditional way of doing it, because I use acrylic paints instead of oils. Now, this style came from the 19th century Russia, and it began by peasants painting floral scenes on everyday items. And I like to continue this tradition by painting the modern everyday item in the traditional Russian folk art. Now, I'll just show you some of the things you will need. Now, obviously, you'll need your blanks. So you might want to paint a keyboard or speakers or any other item. Just make sure that it is made of plastic and there's no soft rubber bits, because you need the blank to be hard so you can paint over it. Now, I'm in Australia, and I use these type of paints. They're the Josonia paints, and I find them to be the best paints for this type of folk art. Now, if you're in the US, you might have trouble finding this brand, so for those of you over there, oops, you can try using this one. This is the folk art acrylics, and you can find them in most craft shops. Now, this is how you to choose the best paint. You want your paint to be quite thick. Now, notice when I put some paint onto here, onto my palette, notice how it stands up. It doesn't create a pool, but it has a lot of thickness to it. Now, this is very good for this style of painting. This is what you want. Now, traditional Russian painters use sable brushes. I use a variety of brushes, but I use a lot of sable. Mostly, if you're going to buy brushes, look for round sable. You'll probably need sizes 2 to 4. And you will need some flat brushes. Probably this one is size 2, but you might need a bigger one if you're going to paint a large item. Yeah, I also paint in different Russian styles. This is the Koklama style and the Gorodets style. But in this in this video, I'll focus more on the Zhostovo style. Now, when you finish painting, you will need to varnish your work. I use this varnish. It's also Josonia. It is a polyurethane water-based varnish. If you can't find any water-based polyurethane, try looking in your local hardware store for a floor varnish. And these are quite easy to find. They're very common for a painting over the floor. But just make sure it's water-based, because oil-based varnish will yellow over time and water-based will not. So I found this brand to be quite good. You will also, this is not necessary, but it's advisable. This is a sealer. Okay, and I will talk more in depth about how to use it, but if you have one, it'd be really useful. It's called all-purpose acrylic sealer. And this is a flow medium. This is something you add to paint to make it, to dilute the paint without losing the opaqueness of the paint. It's useful to have, though not necessary. If you don't have it, don't worry, just use water. But this is useful if you do have it. And this is very important. This is a blending gel. I use a folk art brand because I found this one to be the best. This is something you put onto the surface of your work to blend the colors evenly. It's really useful to have, and I highly recommend it. So it's called a blending gel. Yeah, this is a folk art brand. Yeah, I have read many books about Zhostovo style of painting, And I have over time developed my own style, which is a little bit different from all the other ways of doing it, painting in this style that you'll find in different books. Like I said, I use acrylics, so I had to change some of the technique to fit the medium that we're using. But I think my way of doing it is by far the easiest, because I've read, I think, all the English books on painting in this style, and I've taken bits and pieces from each technique and put them together in the most simple and quick way to achieve the results that you want. Join me next time when I show you my process of painting this computer box in the Russian Zhostovo style.